Hello everyone, welcome to the maths class. You all know that we have started exercise 6.2 along with the property of exterior angle and their properties, right? So I hope you are very much clear with this. So we have started question number one and we have completed. Two was a home assignment which you have done, it was correct. All right, so now in our class, in this class, we are going to start with question number two from exercise 6.2. All right, so along with that, we will also proceed to the fourth property, that is angle sum property. If you look at the list, there are in number four, you have angle sum property. Okay, with that we will proceed to exercise 6.3 also. All right, so stay with me till the end of the video. All right, so student, here we have the question number two from exercise 6.2. All right, so the question is, find the value of unknown interior angle x on the following figures. All right, so you have till now you were finding exterior angle, now you have to find the interior angle. Okay, so using the property similar formula which we did in the yesterday, using that we are going to find this one also. All right, so you all know, we also know that exterior angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of its interior opposite angle, right? So I'm writing here for this question, if you have forgot, exterior angle is equal to, exterior angle of a triangle is equal to, of a triangle is equal to sum of its interior opposite angles, right? Sum of its interior opposite angle. So what is the exterior angle given here? 115 degree, right? So is equal to sum of the interior means 50 plus x. Sum of the interior means 50 plus x. So can you find the value? Yes, why not? 115, this will come here and it will become minus 50 here, and the value of x you are going to get. So when you subtract this, you are going to get the value I'm writing here. X value will be 65 degree. So 115 minus 50 is 65 degrees. So your x value, the other interior angle, is 65 degrees. So when you add this, you are going to get 115. So that will be fulfilled, isn't it? So for the second one also, you are going to apply the same formula, that is exterior angle of a triangle is equal to sum of its interior opposite angle. Interior opposite angle, right? So what is your exterior angle given? It is given, no? So we can write here that exterior angle is given. It is 100. Now sum of the interior means 70 plus x. So I can write 100 minus 70, because this 70 will come here and it will become minus 70. So now when you calculate the value, you are going to get x is equal to 30 degree. So your x value is, the other interior angle is 30. So 70 plus 30 makes 100 degree, no? Is it quite, this is quite logical, so you can directly use this one also, okay? Okay, proceeding forward to question number three, we have this one. So you can see here that exterior angle is given, 125, x value is also, you have to find the x value and you have to find this angle also. So this, you can see here that two interior angles is not mentioned over here, right? Two interior angles are not given, so we can predict that this angle should be 90 degree. Why? Perpendicular is always 90 degree. I have already discussed in altitude, it always makes 90 degree, right? So we can write here x plus 90 is equal to exterior angle, that is 125, right? So x is equal to 125 minus 90. So x is equal to, when you subtract this, 125 minus 90, it is 35 degree. I hope this is understandable. 90 plus 35 makes 125, no? Similarly, here we have the next question, number 4. Its interior is given, x plus 60 is equal to 120. This is the formula. Sum of the interior opposite interior is equal to exterior angle of a triangle. So x is equal to 120 minus 60. This 60 will come here and it will become minus 60. Transposing the value, the sign will get changed. So it is 60 degree. So 60 plus 60 will make 120. All right. Okay, proceeding next to question number 5. Here we have 30 plus x. But student, remember, you have to write the formula. okay, what formula we are using here, that is very important to write. All right, so without writing the formula, do not mention directly the value, as because I have shown you the process, that's why I have not written here the statement or the formula. Formula is very important. The formula I have used here is, once again I'm repeating, that exterior angle of a triangle is equal to sum of its interior opposite angle, right? So interior opposite angle is 30 and x, sum means plus, right? 30 plus x is equal to 80, so x is equal to 80 minus 30, so x is equal to, it is 50 degree. So your x value is 50, so logically you can write 50 plus 30 is 80, no? So this is the way to find, okay, or verify your answer. Similarly, here we have the next one, that 35 plus x is equal to 75. So when you try to calculate the value, what you should get, so x is equal to 75 minus 35, because this will come here, this will come here and become 35, so x is equal to 40 degree. 5 minus 5 is 0, 7 minus 3 4, so it is 40 degree. Alright, so with this we are over with question number 2, exercise 6.2. Also exercise 6.2 we are over with. Now we are going to proceed with the exercise 6.3, okay? But before starting that, exercise 6.3 deals with the another property. Let me write here, another property, the name of the property is angle sum property. Angle sum property, or another name of this property is, the another name also you can give that, or you can write the sum of, not another name, you can say that this is the other, this is the meaning of the angle sum property. Alright, don't say another name, it will not be justified. Okay, so I'll be writing here angle sum property, which is the fourth property, because first property was your median, another median of, or a midpoint of a triangle, another property was altitude, and the third property which we have discussed yesterday is exterior angle of a triangle is equal to sum of its interior, or you can simply write exterior angle of a triangle, in which we have calculated how to find the exterior angle, right? So in this part of the video, we are also going to discuss about the angle sum property, which says that the sum of all the interior angle, all the interior angle of a triangle is 180 degrees. So what does it mean? You all know how many angles are there in a triangle? 3, 1, 2 and 3, angle 1, angle 2 and angle 3. So when you add this angle, angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3, then you are going to get the value 180 degree. This is supplementary angle, right? So angle sum property state that the sum of all the interior angle of a triangle is, interior angle means 1, 2, 3, this is inside the triangle, that's why interior angle. We do not get confused. So when you add this 3 triangles here, you are going to get 180 degree. This is the concept, this is the fourth property. So now, using which we are going to solve exercise 6.3. all right so let us start our exercise 6.3. All right so student, here we have the question number 1 from exercise 6.3. So the question is, find the value of the unknown x in the following diagram. As I have mentioned, the property using which you have to solve this property, okay, you solve this problem or question number 1. Okay, so the part 1 is here. So just see, interior angle is given x, 50 and 60. So your question is, find the value of the unknown x in the following diagram. Okay, so here I'm going to use the concept of angle sum property. What does this angle sum property state? Angle sum property state that the sum of all the interior angle, the sum of all interior angle is 180 degree. So if you have to write, how you are going to write? So x plus 50 degree plus 60 degree is equal to 180 degree. This is what it is trying to say, that is sum of all interior angle, and interior angle are x, 50 and 60. So if you are going to add, this will follow the property of angle sum property, that result in 180 degrees. So when you add this, so x plus 50 plus 60 is 110, Sorry, 50 plus 60 is 100. Okay, student, proceeding forward to the part 3, we have similar type of a question. Using the Angle-sum property, we are going to solve this. That is 30 plus 110 plus x is equal to 180 degree. Now, if you add this, what are you going to get? Of course, 140 degree. Right? You should be very perfect with addition and also subtraction, because when you transpose this, if there is minus sign when you bring here, then it will be plus. If you have plus sign, when you bring this side, it will become minus. So x is equal to 180 minus 140. X is equal to 40 degree. Alright, so moving on to the part 4. So you have this type of question here. Alright, so 50 plus x plus x. Okay, so two opposite interior angle is x plus x. Okay, no problem, we can solve it. So how to solve? Just see. We are using the angle sum property. We are doing, that is, sum of all the interior angle is 180 degree. So 2x plus 50 is equal to 180 degree. Now 2x is equal to, because x plus is, when you have a variable, there is no coefficient or no number is mentioned, then you can add the number. But you cannot add x plus y, you cannot write 2xy. Alright, so this is wrong. When you have the same variable, only at that time you can add. So this is the advantage over here. Okay. So 2x is equal to 180 minus 50 degree. Now 2x is equal to 0, 8 minus 5 is 8 minus 5 is 3 and 130. So x is equal to 130 by 2. Your value is 65 degree. Alright, so you got the value x, that is 65. Okay. Okay, student, we have two more questions left. That is number 5 and number 6. Alright. So, using the same property, we are going to do this one also. Alright. So, this one, number 5 and number 6, you will try it yourself. Okay. If there is any problem, you can ask me. Okay. So, this is x given here. All the interior angle is x. X plus x plus x is equal to 180. 3x is equal to 180. 60 will be your answer. If you are having problem, you can ask me. So here the perpendicular sign is there, 90 degree. So add it, using the angle sum property. It is very, very easy. You are going to get the value of x. Okay. So in the next class, we will proceed with the question number 2 of exercise 6.3. All right. So till then, do your home assignment. Do not forget to practice. All right. Thank you, everyone.